Hi, my name is Clarence Peters and you're watching Hits African Screen. I started working unofficially when I was 9, then I started working officially when I was 13. I didn't start doing music videos at all until I was about, started getting involved with music videos until I was about 21. That was really much just on the side, really. It was like 1, 2, 3, it was on Sultan's videos, the videos after Jack Bojanti's, just there. When I got in film school, I worked on a few music video projects, and then some as proper movies. Then I got back and, well, at the time I couldn't function in Nollywood as it was designed then. And ads are very far and few in between. So the only other place I could express myself artistically seemed to just be music videos. So, yeah. I don't think I've conquered music videos. I don't think it's possible for you to conquer a sector. I think conquer is is a big word, for lack of a better word. But in terms of other things, I run a record label, Capitol Hill Music. That's something that we've been running for the past, I think, 5 years now. And yes, I am shooting a movie at the end of this year, either the last quarter of this year or the first quarter of next year, one of the two. Well, I admire a lot of actors. I don't know too many of the new school actors, but I admire quite a bit. But when we do get to shoot the movie, it's pretty much going to be very known faces, very new faces, people that you've never actually seen act before, because I tend to feel more comfortable with people who the experience is new, they're fresh, so you can mold them into the character that you want them to be in. But the only person that I know right now that's for fact that I'll either kill him or he will kill me if I don't, that has to be in what we're working on now, is Gideon. That's the only person that I think is confirmed for now. The movie is a Nigerian adaptation of the Quentin Tarantino's The Reservoir Dogs. That's all I can say now. If you want me to say it again, I'll say it. The movie is a Nigerian interpretation of Quentin Tarantino's The Reservoir Dogs. Watch The Reservoir Dogs and you know what genre it is. It's not necessarily set into, I don't know, you could call it thriller, you could call it whatever it is. When you're making movies, except the script is deadlocked into a certain genre, I never really think in terms of genres. I don't think I'm necessarily even giving it the thought of what genre it is yet. Alright, so I go to the shrine a lot because as far as I'm concerned, there's no definition of what the Nigerian screenplay is. When people write screenplays, they say that it's in English or it's in Yoruba. But when we have conversations, people can jump between Pidgin, between English, going to Yoruba. It's a blend, it's a weave. But you need to, if you're going to write as a writer, you need to completely understand that. Now, that's one thing for the writer. Then it's another thing to be able to actually shoot these environments. Because as far as I'm concerned, they are the realest environments. If you go to the island, a lot of people faking. All right, I'm not being true, but the mainland is pretty much where you get most of the real people. Alright, so those are the most interesting characters to actually portray. It's the same challenges anyone has in production in Nigeria. It's the same thing. Alright, you can't predict how things will go. It's pretty much the fact that you can't predict, so you have to be able to think on the fly and actually work on the fly, right? It's kind of hard to actually plan that thing, because everything that can go wrong will go wrong. That's the biggest challenge anybody goes through. For film, I've seen movie scripts, they're this thick.